Motion
to open debate.
That is in order.
These about the indigenous languages and make sure that they still have a place in society.
Should minority languages have legal attention from governor?
While promoting national unity.
It's a very important case that we have here.
And I do believe that the ICJ has jurisdiction to rule.
About is whether the ICJ has jurisdiction.
There is a difference between the two governments.
Recognize Palestine as a state, but this case depends on the statehood of Jerusalem.
One of the most controversial issues in the world.
Greetings, delegates. If my appearance is unfamiliar to you, it is because I am disguised in the uniform of the most esteemed members of the local population.
Which would be more cost efficient.
Several local inhabitants who identified themselves as Turner Fenton kids looked upon me with envy.
I dare say you will not believe the horrors I've experienced this past morn.
The Nilfgaard expansion.
That a rebellion could be dangerous considering the current Nilfgaard expansion.
Rather, a deceitful nature.
Either take Radovid out of power or assassinate.
Why are you wearing that?
Why? I don't know.
Territories and land disputes have been changed. The Germanic principalities bordering France have been occupied by France themselves. Napoleon has not formally released a statement as to what his intentions are. But actions need to be taken soon, as any intention is likely not the best for this committee.
My soon-to-be subjects, your time to yield for the great French people has come now.
Now is the time to look out for the interests of the animals. If you want to become ruler, you can become ruler, but you'll be ruling nobody. What we need to do now is fix the water problem.
Dear relative, I've been worried and stressed with the amount of hate I've been getting.
Oh my god, Joe! It's your mama! What happened?
Oh my god, Mom, I'm dying!
Shame on you. You couldn't choose what to do with Joe, and now look what happened.
Capri Sun, I don't know. I think it's Tropicana, I'll be honest.
I have no suspicions. I don't understand why somebody would try to go against me.
Like, this is Utopia's alley, like a utopia. You can do whatever you want here.
Welcome, delegates. Today we'll be playing a game of Candyland, and the current king was crowned.
It is with a heavy heart that I inform you all that our king is dead. We invite you all to join us in a moment of silence.
I am the true heir of Candyland.
I will be running to be your new king.
If you guys need money, make sure to talk to me at that.
We'll have no bold moves. We will have neon highlighted moves.
If anyone wants, hit me up. We'll be partners.
Come to this pageantry. Try to hate us. I got my question for you today. What you plan to put on Candyland's plate?
Well, Toxic Waste and I want no war and only peace. Down with the king and queen. And here we are cooking beans.
All right, I see what you mean there, buddy. I want to ask your friend Toxic Waste something funny. Yo, today you bring here with your friend a new treatment that's gonna bring us an end. My question here for you today is what you gonna do in our country for us with something, yay.
Good afternoon, delegates from all delegations, and welcome to the closing ceremonies of CPSS Mon 8. My name is Justin Schickschneid. I am the teacher advisor for our club at Central Peel, and it's my privilege to have organized this event with my secretariat, and really it was the secretariat more than me. I am more always the paper pusher. But I always say that, you know, behind good delegations is always a good staff member. And I just like to thank basically everybody here today for their participation. That being said, I'd like to introduce our guest speaker for closing. It's our former Secretary General from 2016, Kyle Monte. And he's just going to give a little bit of words in terms of his experience with Mun and why it had such an impact on him. So I'll pass it over to Kyle now. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this year's conference at Central Peel. My name is Kyle Monti, and I was the Secretary General of Central Peel's Model United Nation in the 2016 and 2017 school year. Today, I just wanted to come on and speak to you about what Model UN has done for me and a little bit about the Kyle Monti Award at the end. Now, in high school, I was never really one to do much extracurriculars until grade 11, when Mr. Schicksnight really started pushing Model UN to our entire law class. It sounded pretty interesting, so I signed up and ended up going to my first conference that November called SICSUM. Now, SICSUM was an excellent experience, and I met a lot of people I still keep in touch with to this day. It was also one of the biggest reasons I chose to do my undergrad at the University of Toronto. But that same year, we held our first conference here at Central Peel, where I was supposed to run a joint crisis committee on the Fallout video game series. But it actually needed to be trimmed down to a single committee because we didn't have enough people sign up to fill both rooms. Now, the following year is when I became the club secretary general. We ran two more conferences that year where I ran an ad hoc in both. The second committee I ran was based on the Terminator franchise, where Mr. Schicksnight came in dressed as Arnold and escorted delegates out of the room while the Terminator theme blared. Now, we recorded many videos of that, but it seems I wasn't able to find any of them, so I guess that moment will be lost for time. Now, going into university, I knew I wanted to run more committees. I was never too big on sitting in a committee and debating, but I loved creating the stories and characters that allowed others to be creative. So I knew SICSUM would be the perfect place for me to do this. But I ended up running several committees over my university career at several different conferences, from five-way integrated crises about narco trafficking to single-room committees about the Vietnam War. But by the time I was in my fourth year of university, I had worked at three different conferences at the University of Toronto, and I was actually the Secretary General of SICSUM, the conference that had started it all for me. Now, over the years, I've met a lot of people while participating in Model UN, many of whom are some of my best friends now. Model UN has allowed me to access my creative side and build worlds and scenarios that bring others in excitement, joy, and a challenge as they attempt to navigate them. Well, at least I hope. I hope you can all think back on Model UN one day, like I am right now, and say that it helped you find your strengths and your interests, because it sure helped me find mine.
Central Peel Secondary School is situated in what we now call Brampton, Ontario. This land has long been the traditional territory of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation, who are direct descendants of the Mississaugas of the Credit. And prior, it was the traditional territory of many Métis, Ojibwe, Chippewa, Huron, Wendat, Haudenosaunee, and Anishinaabe. When European explorers arrived in the 15th century, they began settling on these lands and colonizing its people. With the strategic control of trade, resources, and settlement, the Europeans brought upon the largest genocide of people the modern world has seen. Disease, isolation, the usage of residential schools, as well as political silencing were all prominent. In 1818, the Agentin's Purchase gave the government the authority to use this land. And since then, Brampton has developed and changed, but we have not forgotten who was the first to reside here. Currently, many members of the Mississaugas reside on Six Nations of the Grand River. It is important to acknowledge this history of the land that we use and to understand that this acknowledgement is not enough to change the past, but it is a step forward towards reconciliation. The impacts of colonization can still be felt to this day, and although there are 94 calls to action, only 14 have been completed. As people who live, work, and play on this land, it is our duty to pay respects and to recognize the horrors that our Indigenous people have faced. Please take a moment today to reflect on what has happened and what we can do to all help our Indigenous people. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. My name is Kunalaj Thalampally, and I'm one of the Secretary Generals alongside Jasleen Badwal at CPSS MUN 8. We sincerely hope that you had a great time at our conference, and we had a ton of fun organizing it. I'm not going to waste any more of your time, and I'm going to hand it off over to the director of our General Assembly, Benita Kellogg.
Hi, everyone. It has been such a remarkable experience directing the General Assembly of UNESCO at CPSS Monday 8th. In a committee filled with driven delegates of various experience levels, we heard composed, passionate speeches and witnessed solutions being made for the prevalent issues of preserving minority languages and the importance of freedom of press. That being said, we'll start with our awards. The DICE team has read some excellent papers over this weekend, and they have truly blown our minds with their firm stances. However, I would like to present the Shannon Poustasian Award to the delegate whose paper immediately captured the attention of the DICE. With marvelous quotes and phenomenal statistics, congratulations to the delegate of Latvia for a best position paper from North Park Secondary School.
Now moving on to the first recipient of the Ellen Fairclough Award for an honorable mention. This delegate had moving speeches which left the rest of the delegates with something to really think about. They were very active in debate and worked excellently in collaboration with other delegates. I would like to present this award to the delegate of Cambodia from the delegation of Oakville Trafalgar High School. Congratulations, delegate.
The recipient of the next honorable mention gave confident, memorable speeches. They also took a leadership role in their block, driving efforts to reach out to other delegates. The second honorable mention goes to the delegate of Russia from Richmond Green Secondary School. Congratulations, delegate. Our final honorable mention goes to a delegate who also took a leadership role in their block, and they were very active in debate, constantly proposing motions. I would like to give this honorable mention to the delegate of Sweden from The Woodland Secondary School. Congratulations, delegate.
At this time, I am more than honorable to present the Bayard Rustin Award for the delegate who has consistently given powerful, jaw-dropping speeches and led their bloc with confidence. It was truly an honor to watch this delegate work with fellow delegates to present solutions. Congratulations to the delegate of USA from the delegation of St. Teresa of Lizzo Catholic Secondary School for being an outstanding delegate.
Lastly, but certainly not the least, we'd like to present the Romeo Dallaire Award for our best delegate. This delegate truly was a star of our committee. With his stunning, moving speeches and his persuasive tone during UNMAS, he really did embody the country role he was given. As one of the leaders of his bloc, the delegate really understood the mechanics of a General Assembly. We are honored to present the Best Delegate Award to the delegation of Iran from the Woodland Secondary School. Congratulations. Now we'll hand it off to ICJ.
Thank you, UNESCO. It has been our honor and privilege to inaugurate the first ever International Court of Justice here at CPSS MUN. Our delegates have far exceeded our expectations, and we truly mean it when we say the delegates are the one who made this committee the memorable experience it was. Set in a turbulent region, the case that the ICJ tackled was the contentious issue of Palestine versus USA, the movement of the US Embassy to Jerusalem. Despite the challenges presented by both sides of the case, as well as the stringent impartiality of our judges, we were beyond impressed to see how delegates bounced back, being bold, yet purely mentioning a legal stance on the case. Even with the committee being the first of its kind at CPSS MUN, we were taken aback by the overwhelming professionalism and legal understanding that both judges and counsels showcased throughout the duration of the conference. Without further ado, we are honored to recognize the following delegates for their achievement in committee. To start us off, we would like to verbally commend the following delegates for their valuable input to this case and the committee overall. The first delegate we would like to commend is advisor to the Palestine Council, Huwaida Araf. The second member we would like to commend is Judge James Crawford of the International Court of Justice.
At this time, I would like to present the Best Positions Award. This delegate's paper showed an extremely thorough representation of the case, their understanding of the contentious issues revolving the topics at hand, and provided an impartial yet diplomatic perspective to their role. We love seeing this delegate bring what was presented in the paper to the committee. And with that, we are honored to bestow this award upon Judge Julia Sebutinde of the ICJ judges from the delegation of Central Peel Secondary School. Congratulations, Judge.
I'm honored to present our next award, the first of our honorable mentions. This delegate played a paramount role in their counsel, ensuring that their legal arguments were as sound as possible, whilst answering the judges' questions in a coherent and persuasive manner. Their passion for their character's nation's objectives was commendable and continuously reinforced through debate. At this time, I would like to present this award to the co-agent of Palestine Council, Ms. Robin Solomon, from the delegation of North Park Secondary School. Congratulations, agent.
Our next honorable mention is amongst the delegates representing the judges of the ICJ. This delegate brought forward a bold yet critical perspective to their role throughout the entirety of the running of the court, from introducing censorious interpretations and questions to the arguments presented by both parties of the case, to analyzing the consequences of decisions made by the court at the end. This judge's passion to implement an equitable and legally sustainable resolution is shown throughout the representation of their character. And as such, I am privileged to recognize Vice President Kirill Shaborzhian of the ICJ judges from the delegation of Richmond Hills Secondary School as a deserving recipient of this award. Congratulations, Judge.
Our final honorable mention is awarded to the delegate that has continuously impressed Dais with their strong speeches, bold opinions, and stringent stances, all pertaining to the case. Preserving a strong front despite the many challenges presented by the opposition, as well as the judges, I'm beyond honored to bestow the honorable mention upon the advisor to the USA Council, Ms. Linda Thomas Greenfield, from the delegation of Central Peel Secondary School. Congratulations, delegate.
At this time, I am honored to present the Outstanding Delegate Award of the ICJ. This delegate displayed great leadership, especially in unmoderated discussions, and maintained diplomacy in his communications to other delegates. Their speeches were always very substantial, with incredible use of rhetoric, and this delegate showed great focus on the pertinent topics of the committee. They encouraged others to participate while maintaining commendable presence in committee, and truly emulated the spirit of Model United Nations. And with that, we are honored to bestow this award upon President Gilbert Guillaume of the ICJ judges from the delegation of Mary Ward Catholic Secondary School. Congratulations, President Guillaume. It was a pleasure to have you in committee.
And at this time, I'm beyond honored to present our final award for this congregation of the ICJ, the Best Delegate Award. This delegate's utmost professionalism, respectful handling of critical challenges presented by the court, and outstanding leadership in guiding the USA Council continue to impress the dais throughout the entirety of the running of this court. While this case brought the complex intricacies revolving around the historical, political, and legal climate of the region at hand, this delegate was able to handle allegations, arguments, and opposition with skill. I would like to take the privilege at this time to present the Best Delegate Award to the agent, to the USA Council, Her Excellency Ms. Jennifer Newstead from the delegation of Richmond Green Secondary School. Congratulations, agent. It was a pleasure having you join us in committee today.
And with that, congratulations to all delegates of the ICJ are in order. We want to take this time to thank you all for your skill, diligence, and the efforts you have showcased over the past couple of days. In addition, on behalf of my co-directors and myself, I'd like to thank our staffers, Mehtab Chima, Mehar Sigut, and Khadija Muhammad. The court has officially adjourned proceedings. And with that, we'd like to hand it off to Europa Bella.
Thank you, ICJ.
Honestly, a lot of really interesting arcs have unfolded these past days. First being that we had an international student join us. Otherwise, we had Great Britain betray all of the coalition while they themselves were the leader of that coalition itself. We had Russia and Austria form a very interesting alliance to conquer Ottoman land. We watched Spain crumble over the past few days to a mere two states and a few islands. As we watched Napoleon and Marshal Edward Siegfried enact drip policies and present amazing speeches during the war. We even had some really good action amongst the minor nations, seeing various Germanic states and principalities fight over land, specifically Nassau, faking a border conflict to justify a war for personal gain. Honestly, we really didn't expect our committee to turn out this way. We really expected France to lose, but I guess Napoleon was just too good in this committee. So now I'll be moving on to awards. Probably one of the most difficult things for us to decide on this committee, as personally, there were a few more people we wish we could commend, but we were limited. So with that, I'll move it on.
So while it's very difficult for us as directors to pick take the recipients for awards, there was one certain delegate that was challenged throughout the entire committee from the very beginning, from noble uprisings to the threat of civil war to Napoleon just simply walking into her country. Sophie Zhang from Woodland Secondary School, as Queen Maria I, really outdid herself and receives a verbal commendation award. Then, while many position papers that we received were quite amazing in their quality and the skill of the writers, this one was quite elaborate. It was detailed, it was just what we were looking for, and it surprised us at every turn, explaining every topic to areas that we didn't even think we could consider. So the Best Position Paper Award goes to Pope Pius, who is Abigail Kwan from Richmond Green Secondary School. Thank you for an amazing position paper. What a great read. So again, as we stated before, we wish we had more awards to hand out, but this delegate changed the entire course of the committee. From being the main actor for fighting against Napoleon to taking Napoleon's side, we have our very own Sir Arthur Wellesley from the United Kingdom. John Kandakos was so instrumental in the crisis arcs he helped form. His actions matched those of the United Kingdom perfectly. He schemed against coalition members, he fought a war against his allies, and even became friends with France, an absolute roller coaster of emotion. And so he's given the Honorable Mention Award. Now for the Outstanding Delegate Award, it goes to the Russian Empire and Alexander I of Russia. Mohit Babak did not hold back on his expansionism. I mean, he literally annexed quite a lot of the Ottoman territory, and he wielded the true power he knew he had as a Russian state. He defended the Pope against Sardinian attacks, and he continuously annexed land where he could. Truly a wonder to watch in action and prevail in this committee. And his interactions with crisis were so meaningful and really made us think and gave us a challenge. And so he gets the Outstanding Delegate Award. Now, drum roll, everyone. Our Best Delegate Award goes to the Holy Roman Emperor Francis II, whose name is Eli. So Eli is from Applewood Heights Secondary School. And we cannot explain how amazing it was to have this delegate just create all these crisis arcs for us and take us down pathways that we didn't even consider. His actions were absolutely extraordinary. He expanded his glorious Holy Roman Empire. He quote-unquote liberated Christian lands from the Ottoman Empire working with Russia. And he also was very active in the back room, sending back and forth valuable notes. He formed alliances, he abandoned his allies, and he took on isolationist policies when things didn't exactly work out the way he wanted it to. He never stopped fighting against Napoleon, so that's always a plus.
Congratulations again to all the delegates. It has been an honor to be your moderator, and I speak for everyone on our team when I say you have done an amazing job. With the wonderful plot twists and betrayals, you did your best against the French Emperor Napoleon Bonaparte. Now we'll hand it off to Lion King.
Thank you, Europa. Lion King was quite the committee. Starting off in the dry desert lands of Pride Rock, the committee was anything but dry.
From assassinations to reincarnations, and even direct conversations to gods, the Animal Council put forward a united front to save the future of Pride Rock. And with that, had a lot of ambition. They worked together to restore water, peace, and even the land to Pride Rock, hoping to make a society like no other.
At the end of the day, they narrowly escaped their own deaths, waged war against the Communist Party, and used a Ouija board to talk to the spirit of Scar himself. We're just all glad we're not lying on the cold, hard ground.
The whole committee was truly a pleasure to direct, and all of the delegates were more than great. We thank them dearly for their very interesting interpretations of the background guide, enthusiastic speeches, and punny crisis notes.
We will now be presenting the awards for the Lion King Committee. This was a very difficult decision for us, as our committee was full with skilled and hardworking delegates. But without further ado, we are so honored to introduce the awards for this crisis committee.
Our first award, the verbal commendation, is to an excellent speaker throughout the conference, bringing forth passionate points and voicing their points incredibly well. It was truly a pleasure to watch them defend themselves so eloquently, even when being accused of murder, and to contribute to the movement of the committee. This goes to Rafiki. Congratulations, delegate.
Our next commendation also goes to an extremely active delegate, one who took charge when the committee had only 10 minutes to save themselves from murder by the threatening Caden, the Komodo dragon. They expressed their opinions and pushed for a change throughout the entirety of the conference, and it was wonderful having them in this committee. Congratulations, Timon.
There was one special delegate who crafted an incredibly well-positioned paper, clearly outlining their stances and perfectly providing reasons for their choices. They even went out of their way to research real-world statistics and apply them to their planned action and stances for the world of Lion King. The Best Position Paper Award goes to Pa. Congratulations.
Moving on to honorable mention, there was a very passionate delegate who did not move their ground even when the whole committee was accusing them for the murder of Scar. In the back room, their crisis notes were incredibly funny to read with plenty of Taylor Swift puns and Canva integrated pieces of media. Sure, maybe they did murder Scar, but they made up for that very controversial crime by voicing their opinions with drive and framing everyone they possibly could. This award goes to Zazu. Congratulations.
And now for the outstanding delegate. This delegate was a passionate one who drove for change and was not afraid of making decisions that would bring the committee success. They spoke on almost every topic, ensuring that his opinions were always taken into consideration when crafting public directives. In the back room, they did not hold back when it came to furthering and accelerating the committee. They even went as far as flirting with Caden the Komodo dragon, the communist dragon, to ensure that they had some say when it comes to the political landscape of Pride Rock. Even though they were kidnapped and at the hands of poachers by the end, they were a pleasure to have in the committee. Congratulations, and this award goes to Nala.
Lastly, our Best Delegate Award. This delegate was an excellent delegate who succeeded in both the front and the back room. They pushed for change even when it seemed like there was no light at the end of the tunnel. After experiencing the tragic and the rebirth of tragic death and the rebirth of their father, they were determined to help their people by consistent contribution to the committee. In the back room, they even let their murderous streak show towards the end when they decided to murder Rafiki. But aside from that, they took to the skies and spoke to God themselves on multiple occasions. We are so honored to announce this award to Simba. Congratulations. We thank you all again for making this committee so very fun. Your speeches were very entertaining to listen to, and trust me when I say this, Crisis staff had the best time coming up with updates for you guys.
We had the best time directing this committee. And now, before we hand it off to Star Wars, we wish you the best of luck on your future endeavors. And always remember, Hakuna Matata.
Now, let's take a trip to a galaxy far, far away.
Thank you, delegates. Now we will be discussing the awards that were won by Star Wars.
Star Wars, Star Wars, Star Wars. The amount of notes, directives, and events happening in this fictional galaxy far, far away led to one of the most chaotic storylines, completely different from the Star Wars some of us know and love. From being constantly bombarded with crisis events, having to deal with internal and factional conflict, all these delegates did a phenomenal job, and I would like to congratulate all of you for your great work this weekend.
Some of the events that they had to deal with, including having to improve an intergalactic military, rebuilding the economy, and a civil war. Whether it was dealing trade attacks from me, the elusive Jedi Bob, or building a Death Star, or assassinating fellow committee members, delegates were always on their feet to respond to these crises. We would like to thank everyone for making this committee fun for us and fellow delegates. Without further ado, we'll now go on to our first award.
So starting off with awards, we have the verbal commendation. We first want to give a verbal commendation to a delegate who was always quick to respond to every crisis arc with dignity and take initiative and group directives where necessary. This delegate was very active in debate and had some very great speeches throughout the committee. Their work in moving the others' hearts and minds to get things done was amazing. This delegate is none other than Lando Calrissian from Central Peel Secondary School. Well done, delegate.
Now, during committee, this delegate worked hard with their partner to ensure that the rebellion is always prepared for whatever the Empire threw at them. They were a strong advocate against slavery and sometimes worked with the enemy to achieve their means. Their speeches moved us throughout committee, and their position paper gave us a clear outline of their stance on committee topics. For these reasons, the best position paper goes to Subaka from St. Teresa of Lazio Catholic High School.
And with that, we will be moving on to the honorable mention. This delegate's work in this committee was exceptional and led to some of the most interesting moments in this committee. This delegate did phenomenal and was a very strong orator. They had very unique ideas in crisis arts, and their work was very exceptional during this entire conference. They managed to become the leader of Mandalore and work together with the Empire. This delegate is none other than the son of a famed Mandalorian bounty hunter, Boba Fett from St. Michael's College School.
And now we'll be moving to the Outstanding Delegate Award. This delegate was really active in the backroom, creating developments in technology, as well as aiding Darth Vader on his mission to retrieve Luke Skywalker. He argued alongside his fellow Imperial advisors about constructing the Death Star, as well as advocating for a strong military for the Empire. Without further ado, the award for Outstanding Delegate goes to the head of the Department of Advanced Weapons Research, a member of the Tarkin Initiative, Director Krennic from North Park Secondary School.
Congratulations, Delegate. And now we are moving on to the Best Delegate. Now, this delegate was always at the forefront of the front and the back room, constantly creating conflict, solving conflict, building bases on planets, to building an entire clone army, and also invading neutral planets. They worked with other Imperial officers to build a Death Star and ensure that Imperial demands come out on top. This is the moment we've been waiting for, the best delegate, the one who was leading the Galactic Civil War from the forefront. And the best delegate goes to a member of the Strategic Advisory Cell, the regional governor of the Outer Rim Territories, the one and only Grand Moff Wilhuff Tarkin from Chinkuzi Secondary School. Congratulations, delegates.
We would like to congratulate all delegates who have won an award. And we would like to let everyone know that you did an outstanding job in committee. Your debates were entirely moving for us directors to hear, and we wish you all the best luck in your future conferences. And without further ado, we will hand it off to Witzer.
Thank you, Star Wars. The world of Witcher turned out to be quite the memorable experience for both delegates and staff. Delegates were tasked with resolving a conflict plagued between three giant entities, pursuing peace at every turn, even when war seemed on the horizon. They faced the wrath of an imperialistic empire, the ill intentions of some delegates, and even a multitude of rebellions. From botched assassinations to coup d'etat and even attempted murder, delegates pulled every trick in their bag, making committee session extremely enjoyable, and delegates spoke passionately with purpose, embodying their characters' movements and motivations, springing this universe to life. I would like to congratulate all delegates for their effort. I would like to congratulate all delegates for their efforts this weekend.
Now let's move on to awards. This is a tough feat to do, especially because we had such variety of excellent delegates in our committee. First off, we would like to give a verbal commendation to Tris Marigold from SCL. This delegate displayed utmost diplomacy, even in times of chaos and conflict. They were able to de-escalate situations and problem solve with finesse. Their comments are very insightful and drove the committee forward. Our next award is Best Position Paper. The award of Best Position Paper goes to Sigismund Dijkstra from Chinguzi Secondary School. This delegate voices opinion eloquently and with a strong sense of well-formatted end goal. During committee sessions, their presence was felt in discussions and carved the thoughts of other delegates, even in topics they didn't have an inherently powerful position in. Moving on to our next award, the honorable mention goes to Jennifer Evangerberg from Brampton Centennial Secondary School. This delegate was a joy in the back room, with carefully crafted notes with immense detail and creative media, such as propaganda flyers. They utilized their extensive knowledge of the content by making interesting references and even incorporating the complex magic system in the world of Witcher. Even after being put in precarious situations, they were able to persevere and move forward. Now let's have a look at the Outstanding Delegate Award. The Outstanding Delegate Award goes to Amir Var Emris from Chingusi Secondary School. This delegate was truly a mastermind in every sense of the word, taking advantage of crisis updates and other delegates' positions by taking decisive actions. They played their role to perfection and recognized the pros and cons of their position by aligning themselves with allies that fit their goals for the moment. Despite being the scapegoat and a true villain, they were able to evade a total of 4 assassination attempts and ironically fake their own death. In the front room, their speeches, while being opposing parts of the committee, were able to influence the neutral positions and gain allies in places they didn't expect. Now for the last award. The award for best delegate goes to Sirius Ancre from Centropil Secondary School. This delegate was an absolute joy to have in The Witcher this year. From sponsoring every public directive that passed to attempting to create a proxy empire, this delegate's creativity and unique outlook in committee was sensational. Crisis even singled her out for a few updates by threatening her position and pushing her into a corner, which she masterfully evaded by regaining her position. She was a centerpiece in dismantling 2 empires, truly establishing herself as a powerful delegate. Thank you for everybody who attended The World of Witcher. We will now hand it off to Ad Hoc.
Okay, thank you so much, The World of Witcher. This year, Ad Hoc was all about orange juice, Justin Bieber, and vacationing in Hawaii. Now, you would think it's a pretty relaxing, laid-back committee, but God, it was the exact opposite. Now, you might even have heard from other delegates part of our committee that Ad Hoc was about the circus. Again, the exact opposite. In all seriousness, our committee, known as the Circadian Order, was all about the mystery of the REM files, which stands for Replace and Extract Memories. Based on the movie Inception, the government had been secretly planting memories, specifically the current president of the United States, to steal the presidency from our former president, Anna Chambers, and to create absolute chaos on US soil. Delegates were trying to find out who this person named Phoenix was, the man that was behind all of the file stealing.
They never thought it was their own government betraying them, but slowly by the end of committee session, they discovered that their president was Phoenix, this character that caused chaos around the world just so he could get into power. From kidnappings to buying henchmen named Octoberthigan, Spygit, Mr. Steal Your Girl, Mr. Steal Your Man, and gadgets like the Beast presidential car worth 10 resource points, which were our currency, were used in our committee. Our committee entailed a lot. So now on to our first award, the verbal commendation.
All right, this delegate consistently participated throughout the committee, whether it be uniquely motioning in the front room or sending quite the creative private directives. They always made sure to make their voice heard and further their character's objectives accordingly. It was a true joy to see their progression throughout the committee, handling every crisis curveball we sent towards them.
With that being said, I would like to verbally commend Saksha Mittal from North Park for playing the character of Morpheus to an outstanding degree and infusing him with creative and entertaining ideas in both front and back room.
This delegate was simply amazing in the back room, Working behind the scenes with this delegate in this back room was a truly amazing experience. Their beautifully constructed and thought out private directives were an absolute delight to read. From hiring and bribing a psychologist for national television to even trying to impersonate the president, this delegate's creative ideas helped keep the committee sessions that much more exciting. I would be honored to congratulate Matthew Cianchetti from St. Michael's College School, who played Nick Sconi in this committee, for this honorable mention award.
This next delegate was simply amazing in the back room, making simple yet creative arcs, where she introduced characters like our boy, Belfrost Munkin, who searched through the files to find remnants of a quote-unquote god of dreams. She even brought out her sister, the Valorant gamer with the Nerf gun, to protect her in a trial. This delegate even wrote in her diary, trying to reform her game addiction and finding true inner peace within the world. When she was kidnapped, this diary became a piece of paper. She kept on writing no matter where she was until the very end of the committees, which is why she was a true inspiration. She handled all her accusations in the front room extremely well, which is why I'd like to congratulate Nadeem Akiloy, played by Jasmine Alouk from CPSS, with the honorable mention award from the ad hoc committee.
All right, now moving into our outstanding delegate, where do I even begin with this delegate? This delegate did the absolute most, from creating the most atrocious yet creative arcs in backroom to his phenomenal acting in the front room, and he covered essentially all of his bases. He, alongside other members in the committee, created a spy group known as the Court of Owls that helped to maintain law and order within the outside and within the committee. Not to mention that this delegate got kidnapped and yet in all bravery decided that he was going to take a bullet for his fellow delegates. He died a hero and then decided to reenact his tragic passing. I'm proud to say, and I'm proud to name, Chavez Lin, played by the one and only Camber Rizvi from Chinkuzi Secondary School, as the outstanding delegate for ad hoc.
All right, on to the best delegate. I am so honored to present this award to a delegate who went above and beyond. I mean, he literally went above and beyond. At one point, we had this delegate standing up and giving speeches while also simultaneously just sobbing, crying his eyes out. Delegates in our committee, for some reason, could not figure out a two-letter cipher. And this delegate screeched when he found out it was the president behind this. Yes, indeed. It was the president that was behind the Capri Sun companies being purchased. He was definitely the key to the puzzle. Loren, you communicated with Bob Raj Singh, your Stanford homeboy, to help you get some photogenic memory stuff. Imagine I am drinking orange juice when I'm saying this ad hoc committee, and to outsiders who believe our committee is about the circus, congratulations to Loren Sivan, Anish Neethi Ganesh from Richmond Green Secondary School. You are the best delegate for ad hoc. Thank you for making a national dream census and indirectly roasting OJ or orange juice, because you know apple juice will always be the best. I want to thank all delegates for an amazing moderating and directing experience. I truly had such a hard time deciding between delegates for awards with the ad hoc team that also has the best mugs. I will leave you with this famous inside joke we began with. The circus must go on. Thank you to every clown in our committee for making this an amazing experience. Justin Bieber's legacy will live on. And now I'll be handing it off to Katrina to discuss the midnight crisis.
Thank you, Ms. Khan, and thank you, Ad Hoc. This year, our midnight crisis delegates found themselves in Candyland, an alternate universe, and one that had just undergone serious political disarray, as the king of Candyland had just been killed. In two quick hours, delegates accused each other of the murder, tried to take over the new government for themselves, and of course, who could forget the rap battle? We would be remiss to not mention any of the iconic campaign slogans that delegates brought out, such as, "Let's go Sweden," in a land where there was, in fact, no such thing as Sweden. Political strife, attempted fraud, and many, many attempts to rig elections defined this committee, and we were seriously impressed by the work of our delegates. Thank you to our front room staff, Abhishek and Panal, as well as our backroom staff, Anant, Caitlin, Harlene, Jasleen, Shreya, Dhruv, Tanasia, and Vanita. And with that, I'll pass it over to Abhi.
Thank you, Kat. I also want to take this moment to thank all of our incredible staff, as well as the amazing delegates who came out. Nobody really had to do this, especially after a long day of committee sessions. But you guys were the reason why this committee was so much fun and my personal highlight of CPSS month. With that being said, we will start off with our verbal commendation award. This delegate was amazing in the front room. Despite being given his character on such short notice, this delegate was able to cultivate a rich story and truly felt as one with his character. When this delegate spoke, everybody listened due to their bold and direct approach. Without further ado, I'd like to present the Midnight Crisis verbal commendation to Lafayette Taffy, or Andy Feng, from Mary Ward Catholic High School. Next, we have the award for our best delegate. This goes to a delegate who did a commendable job in striking the balance between front room and back room activity, planning devilish crisis plot lines and ultimately succeeding in achieving their character's goal. This delegate tried double crossing every character in committee and still had time to engage in an epic rap battle and drop some cold, hard bars to everyone's amazement. I am ecstatic to present this award to JJ Rizzo, or Jacob Green of the Woodland Secondary School. I will now hand it off to Jasleen to talk about delegation awards.
Thank you, Abhi. This year, we had 13 schools and almost 200 delegates in attendance. Delegates came from around the GTA and some even joined internationally, making this conference our largest that we have ever hosted. That being said, it is my honor to present the delegation awards. These awards are given out to the delegations that received the most total delegate awards. Using the system of points being allotted based on the type of award received, we calculated totals based on best delegate awards receiving 4 points, outstanding receiving 3, honorables receiving 2, and paper awards receiving 1. Before we award the top 2 delegations, let it be known that every delegate was truly incredible in their committee and certainly made their delegation very proud. That being said, as you can see, Mr. S has with him the Malika Abau Award for the most outstanding delegation, which goes to Central Peel Secondary School, and the Yashod Ramsa Award for the best delegation on the screen right now, Richmond Green Secondary School. Thank you, all delegations, once again.
And now, before we officially adjourn this conference, I wanted to give a huge thank you to all of the delegates and faculty advisors who have spent the past few days with us. You've made this conference what it is today. We appreciate all of the feedback that was given, and we'll continue to work hard to make our conference better every single year. On that note, we'll also be sending an optional delegate feedback form in the coming days so that we can improve for CPSS Mon 9. This year was an amazing experience, and we saw things from rap battles to Darth Vader with a Mon shirt to crisis analysts dressed up as animals while making videos to give updates. We are incredibly thankful for all of the work everyone has put in. And lastly, a huge thank you goes to the Secretariat for putting this conference together. In alphabetical order, thank you to Abhishek Ganesan, Caitlin Zerafino, Katrina Morris, Gurleen Rangi, Harleen Shokar, Crystal Grover, and Shivam Suri, and of course, my co-secretary general, Jasleen Badwal. With that being said, I'd like to hand it off to Crystal Grover to close off this conference. Thank you.
CPSS Mon 8 is officially adjourned.